I'm Gary Fellers. I work for the U.S. Geological Survey, and I do research on bats and other kinds of animals, both at Point Reyes and in San Francisco, specifically at Fort Funston. I like to be out at night. I like to study nocturnal animals, and I've had a long interest in animal vocalization. Most bats are vocalizing in a range that at the low end would be maybe 8 or 10 kilohertz, and it will range up to about 100 kilohertz. Most of the bat vocalizations fall well outside the range that anybody can hear. For a monitoring station, I will have one of these anabat detectors set up, you know, a waterproof box on the outside of a building. What we look at is the frequency range for the bat vocalization. Some are much higher frequency than others. The pulse repetition, how rapidly the bat is giving a vocalization, and the range of frequencies that the vocalization sweeps through. Bat vocalizations that are picked up and then played through the speaker on the anabat have been lowered by a factor of 16, so it falls within the range of almost anybody. The Mexican free-tailed bat is one of the most common bats in this area. It's also a bat that will vocalize down to about 10 or 20 kilohertz, and so if you have very good hearing, some people can hear the Mexican free-tailed bat. Bats need to vocalize at a high frequency because the wavelength is very short and it provides the bat more detailed information about the environment. Bats have a variety of vocalizations. One is what we call a search phase vocalization, which is what they normally use. They're flying around and they're searching not only for food, but they're searching for obstacles like telephone poles and trees that they don't want to fly into. When they detect something that might be a food item, the vocalization changes. It increases in frequency, so the wavelength is shorter, the bat is getting more detail about what's in the environment, and the pulse rate greatly increases. The activity of our local bats is actually quite varied. We have some bats like big brown bats, which are one of the more common bats in the San Francisco area. They fly fairly early in the evening. So on a warm summer evening, if you see a bat flying, and especially if it has a very steady, straight flight, it's quite likely to be a big brown bat. The pallid bat is a very late flying bat. And so they don't leave their roost site until it is completely dark outside. The pallid bat flies very slow and very low to the ground. It has excellent hearing. It can actually hear the footsteps of a beetle. The goal of the work that I'm doing at Fort Funston and elsewhere in the Bay Area is to determine what species of bats occur in the area. And then we also get information about seasonal activity. There are some species of bats that are only here during the spring and summer. Others apparently migrate through the area. At Fort Funston, I haven't seen any indication that bats are roosting in or on any of the buildings right there. It's more likely that the bats are roosting in one of the larger trees, either in the foliage, under a bit of bark. They tend not to feed in areas that are particularly windy. It's harder for them to fly, and there are fewer flying insects up in the air. The bats are almost certainly feeding around whatever kind of wooded area or riparian area, or even around some of the lower shrubs.